Quantile regression using the software STATA. Quantile regression finds the regression line that minimizes the sum of the absolute residuals. It can take care of the over dispersion and under dispersion in the data. The traditional linear regression shows the relationship between dependent and the independent variables based on the conditional mean. However, it fails to describe the relationship at different points of y, or dependent variable. On the other hand, quantile regression uses the conditional median or other quartile function instead of mean function. And therefore, quantile regression is more robust to non-normal data and outliers. So if I see from these two graphs that the first one, the line here, the line in this first figure is showing simple linear regression fit, which actually minimizes the sum of squared residuals. Now, if I carefully look at this figure, we can see that there is more dispersion in data when x increases. Okay, so there is more dispersion. And traditional OLS method, they cannot address this dispersion. On the right hand side, the second graph shows quartile regression line. So we have three different quartile regression line. That means that is at 10%, 50% and 90% quartile level. And this line therefore minimizes the sum of absolute residuals and thus minimizes error on both sides. Let's see an example. How can we perform this quartile regression using the software STATA? Here is the STATA data file, and my dependent variable is the greenhouse gas emission, and my independent variables are assets and profitability. So I want to see the impact of assets and profitability on the greenhouse gas emission. So in simple linear regression model, that is OLS, we can run this through command of reg and then greenhouse gas emission, asset, profitability, right? Dependent variable followed by independent variable. So this actually gives us the result of the simple OLS regression. Now, if I want to use the quartile regression, then under the command option, I have to type Q reg. So Q means quartile and the regression, so that means Q reg. And then I need to put my dependent variable first, which is greenhouse gas emission, followed by independent variable. Even press enter, I can see the result of the quartile regression. And by default, quartile regression is based on median regression, that is 50% quartile. And we can see under the OLS, the coefficient was 0.689, but under the quartile regression based on the median, it is 0.701. Although this the significance, the both model shows the significance. Now, if I want to find this quartile regression at different quartile other than the median, we can also find this thing. So again, quireg, and then my dependent variable followed by independent variables. And I can specify at what quartile I want to see. So this Q means quartile, and then in the bracket I need to put the quartile, like it is 10%, 25%, 75%, 90%. So if I type it 0.25 and then press enter, and you can see this result is showing the result based on the 25% quartile, and you see there is change in the coefficient value. We have option of including a robust standard error, and to do this, simply after typing quireg and then dependent followed by the independent variables and the desired quartile, I can type BCE and under the bracket robust. So BCE and then under the bracket robust, this will give you the result based on robust standard error. Okay, so you can see the change in this standard error based on the robustness. And then if we like to get the result simultaneously at different quartile, then we can do this using the command sqreg. So previously it was qreg, now you have to type s. So this s means simultaneous, and then your dependent variable followed by independent variable, and then you can type the quartile. So 0.25, and then I want to see the median or 0.5, and then 0.75. So this will give me the result at 25, 50, and 75% quartile. So if I press enter, I can get this result from here. And this is the pseudo R-square at different quartile levels of 20%, 50%, 25%, 50%, 75%. Now, if I looked at this coefficient value, so for the simplicity, if I only talk about the first independent variable, that is the asset, and in this all quartile, this actually is statistically significant. But if I looked at the coefficient value, and we can find some interesting result here. You can see the coefficient value over the increase of the quartile. You can see this coefficient value also increases from 0.49 to 0.70 and then 1. So to interpret these changes, we can see, or we can say here, that asset has big effect on greenhouse gas emission at higher quartile. And traditional OLS method cannot address this issue, or cannot tell this thing. Next is, if I want to include clustering in our model, we can do this, but this cannot be done using this qreg command. Rather, you need to install a new command that is called qreg2. So to do this, you need to type here ssc install qreg2, and then just a typing error. So write ssc install qreg2 and press enter. And if this command is not installed previously, it will be installed now. Otherwise, it will show that all files already exist and are up to date. So in my case, showing this meaning that I have already installed this command. Now, if I want to do this regression based on industry clustering, then I would type here qreg2 and my dependent variable followed by independent variable. And for example, I want to see it at a 25% quartile, so q.25. And for the clustering based on the industry ID, I need to type C. So C means clustering, and then under the bracket I need to put the clustering variable, that is industry ID. And then industry ID is there, so you need to close that bracket and press enter. So this will give you the result based on 25% quartile when you actually clustered your database on the industry ID. So standard error adjusted for clusters in industry ID. So in this way, we can perform quartile regression in STATA. Thank you.